Hello guys, assalamualaikum and a very good morning. So today I'm going to explain to you a little bit about DSSC process, how it works, about recombination effect that occurs in the photoanode, and also figure C is about the light scattering effect. If you know the basic process of DSSC, you know the big problem that occur at the photoanode, you can increase the power conversion efficiency. So we're going to tackle that problem. Okay, the first thing first, the figure A is about how the DSSC work. So first of all, what happened is the dye, because dye-sensitized solar cell is a solar cell based on the dye. So the first process is the dye itself undergo oxidation process, whereby what happened is it release an electron. The electron, as you can see here, the electron is excited from the ground state to the excited state. So what happened next is the electron moves to the TiO2 photoanode. Here, from one TiO2 molecules to another TiO2 molecules, the electron will travel and the electron goes to the counter electron. For your information, during the transfer of electron at the TiO2 photoanode, it creates electron hole junction. Because when one electron is jumping to another electron, it creates hole which is positive and negative. Positive and negative alternate each other will create a junction which is a voltage. And then the moving electron will create a current. Then the electron moves to the counter electron. As you know that the counter electron act as a catalyst that enable the electron to recombine back with the electrolyte. Then what happened? The electrolyte is a redox type. It undergo oxidation and reduction. So what happened is oxidation of triiodide, oxidation of iodide to triiodide will release an electron. The electron goes back to the dye and the process is complete. Throughout the DSSC process, we are saying that a new power is generated. A new solar energy is generated. Why? Because we learn in physics power, we can generate a power when we have a current and also voltage. So a moving electron carry charge, which carry current, and also we have the voltage from electron hole junction. Okay, this is a figure A, how DSSC work. If you want to study about DSSC, you must first know about how the DSSC work. So move on to the figure B. So we already know a very simple definition on how the DSSC can generate electricity. So however, it's not as easy like that. They have a lot of problem that we must overcome in order to have high power conversion efficiency, in order to have high solar energy. So what happened is this all happened at the photoanode. So what happened is the recombination effects. So as you know that we are saying about the electron is being traveled in one way. So from the dye to the photoanode to the counter electrode to the redox electrolyte and to the dye back. So it must be one way to produce more current and more voltage. That's why it can produce high power conversion efficiency. So what happened is in the figure B, we're going to discuss the main problem. It's all about recombination. What happened before the electron can reach to the dye back, it recombined with unnecessary electron from, let's say, from the photoanode, from the substrate, and it will reduce the power conversion efficiency by reducing the amount of current and also the amount of voltage produced. So what happened, the recombination, the first one, the possibility of the electron to recombine it, what happened after the dye is oxidized and the electron is excited from the ground state to the excited state, what happened? The electron fall back and recombine with the dye. So we know that when this happened, we know that the E of the dye recombine with D plus. D plus is the dye. So what happened is when we excite the electron, it leaving behind the hole. This first recombination step, we call it the recombination of electron of the dye with the hole. It recombine back and become a dye. So means that it reduce the amount of power by so much because the electron because the electron doesn't have time to travel and to produce current and also voltage. The second thing is about the electron already successfully, we call that, is thanks God, the electron successfully go to the TiO2 molecules. So here is already create electron hole junction, already create a little bit of voltage. So what happened? The electron recombine with the redox electrolyte. This is also a type of recombination effect. The last but not least is the electron of the substrate itself. In DSSC, we are using ITO, indium tin oxide class, we are using FTO, also we can use a flexible substrate. So what happened is the electron of the substrate recombine with the redox electrolyte. This is also the possibility that can happen. So they have a lot of ways in order to prevent all this happen. For example, they are using a very good dye like N719 ruthenizer, N719 ruthenium based dye. They are using iodide triiodide to reduce the amount of recombination. However, for the third possibility, the recombination of the electron of the substrate with the redox electrolyte, what they did is they introduced the compact layer or blocking layer in between the substrate and also the TiO2 molecules. This is in order to prevent the electron of the substrate to recombine with the redox electrolyte. And successfully, it's proven in the paper that it's proved when we have a blocking layer that block between the substrate and also photoanode, what happened is we can reduce the recombination effect. And this can be proved by anodic peak current by using the cyclic photometry. Okay, finish about the recombination. If you tackle about this, you can produce a lot of paper. You can produce a lot of novelty in order to improve the power conversion efficiency. And last but not least is figure C. It's about light scattering effect. This is just an example. The theory is quite simple yet tricky in the experiment. Yet the theory said that when we doesn't have anything on top of the TiO2 photoanode like the figure A, so what happened if when the device receives the incident light, a lot of light loss can be seen from the figure. Means that they not fully utilize the sunlight. Because we know that the sunlight is a source of photon, source of energy, a package of energy. This package of energy will hit the dye molecules and it undergo oxidation, and even though throughout the process it will produce a new power. And what happened if we have a light loss, means that we lost the amount of energy to produce a new energy. That's why we introduce a bigger particle on top of the TiO2 mesophorus, which is a TiO2 GQD light scattering layer. It's not necessary to be this molecule, but a study have shown that by having a larger TiO2 molecules on top of the mesophorus structure will block some of the incident light, and this extra energy will excite more electrodes. So you can have high dye loading capacity, you can have high current and also high voltage. So that's the main point, to have something bigger. But you doesn't need, actually the theory is quite simple, having something bigger, we have something bigger on top, but actually it's quite tricky. It's not that everything is bigger can increase the efficiency. So what happened is this thing, you must control the size. At certain limits, it will become resistivity to your material. So your resistance will increase and performance will be dropped. So it's like double-edged sword. You got one thing, you lost one thing. That's the main problem. So hope you understand about how the mechanical happen in the DSSC, the main problem, and also what you going to do to increase the efficiency. I think that's all. Thank you for watching. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Okay, bye. See you in the next video. Please drop a comment if you have any answer. If you want to ask me a question, just drop a comment. Thank you very much.